Hello friends, I am Dr. Nagaraj from Regional Institute of Education, Mysore. With me, the 5th standard students from Demonstration Multipurpose School, Mysore, namely
N. Arunadavan,
Aditya R.
Ashishriyas,
Bhuvana D.
Today, we are going to learn a topic, blow hot, blow cold. Let us begin the topic with a small story. You can watch here. There was a woodcutter. He went to the forest to cut the wood. It was very cold winter. His fingers were becoming numb. He blew on the fingers to warm. Later, to prepare a lunch, he made a chulha. What is chulha?
Wood stove.
Since the wood was damp, he blew on the fire to make it burn. Then he cooked potatoes. He took out a potato from the pot and tried to eat. Since it is hot, he blew on the potato to cool. Then he ate. This is the small story. Now,
sir, I have a
yes, doubt. Arun.
He blew to warm the fingers and cool the potatoes.
Yes.
Blow hot and blow cold. It's same breath. How it is possible, sir?
Very good. Very good question Arun asked. Now, you are going to find the answer yourself by doing some activity. Shall we do the activity?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now, we shall do the first activity. Keep your hand in front of your mouth like this. Blow hard on it. How do you feel whether the air is hotter or colder?
Hotter, sir.
Hotter. Okay, good. Now, you keep it at a distance. Now you blow. Now also, is it hotter or colder?
Colder.
Why such? Adi?
Because of the distance, the breathed air got cool.
Very good. So, because of the distance, the exhaled air or breathed out air got cool. Okay? This is one. Now, think and tell me, is there any other way where we can use this warmth of the air? Any other way? No answer?
Yes, sir.
No answer. Okay. Now, you can take these towels. Fold it 2-3 times. Keep it on your mouth. Blow hard. 2-3 times again. Good. Now you touch and tell me whether it is hot or cold?
Hot.
Now, is there any other way to use? Can you guess? Yes. Harsha?
Sir, when I was playing, okay. I hit the wall.
Okay.
My mom did like this.
How? Very good. Why she did it like that? Now, can you tell me the answer? Is there any other way to use the warmth? Anybody? Yes, Bhuvana?
Sir, we can use the warmth to reduce the swelling.
That is the one way of using the warmth of our breath. Understand? Just now we have seen our breathe out air contains warmth. It is warmth. Okay? Now, next we are going to do another activity. Before that, you tell me, have you ever burnt your tongue while you ate or drank hot items?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Now, I am going to give you some hot food items. Take out this. Take. Each one take one. What is it?
Dal sir.
Sabji.
Rice.
Chapati.
Chapati. Now, how can you show me how will you cool this item? Can you show me how will you cool this item? This hot. Can you show? Yes. Do it. Good. So you will blow on them to cool. Is it not? Now, I would like to have a cup of tea. Do you like to have?
Yes, sir.
Take the tea and have it. What are you doing?
We are blowing.
You are blowing. Why?
To cool it.
To cool it. Okay. Now you tell me, which is hotter? Whether you are breathing, no? That breathe out air is hotter or the tea is hotter?
The tea is hotter.
So in this activity, you found that the tea is hotter than your breath. How was the tea?
Nice, sir.
Good. So after the tea, shall we watch a video?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Watch this video carefully and tell me what is he doing. Watch carefully. Yes, Arun?
She is warming her hands by blowing, sir.
She is warming her hands by blowing because of winter season. Okay, good. Now, tell me here, which is cooler? Her hands or the air she blew? Adi?
Her hands.
Her hands are cooler than the air she blew. Good, very good. Now, you have seen two activities. You had a tea and you have watched the one video. Okay. In these two, in the case of tea, her breath is cooler than the tea. But in this case, her breath is hotter than her
tea.
Hotter than her
hands.
Very good. Good. Like the previous activity, we shall do another activity. Here, tell me, for what other places or other purpose do you blow air? Yes, Harsha?
On paper fan
you blow air. Good. Okay. Do you like to play fan now?
Yes, sir.
Good. Here, I have two fans. One for boys and one for girls. Now, you blow on it. Very good. So, you blow on fan to rotate. Good. Do you find something inside?
Yes, sir.
What is it?
Soap water.
Good. With soap water, what will you do?
Bubbling.
So, for making bubbling also, what you do?
Blow.
Good. You give it to them, let them bubble. Good. Very good. Do it again. Very good. Now you tell me, for what all the purpose or occasions you blow air?
In hot things.
On hot things, then?
For bubbling?
To rotate the fan.
To rotate the fan, very good. Like the previous activity, we shall do one more activity where we are going to blow. Okay? Now, I have some papers and scissors. Each one of you take one paper and one scissor. Now, fold it into half. Fold it. With the scissor, at the center, you make a V-shaped cut and remove that piece. You all got like this, a small hole at the center.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, again, you fold both the end upward. Fold like this. You got like this?
Yes, sir.
You got it? Okay. Keep the paper in between your finger. Just keep it on your mouth and blow. heart. Oh, very good, very good. Now, let us see whose whistle is louder. Shall we see?
Yes, sir.
Okay, to start with Harsha. Very good. Good. Very good. Very good. So, all are equally louder, is it not? All did very good whistle, is it not? Good. Like the paper whistle, can you make the whistle from these things?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes? Okay, you can take the pen cap and do it. Do it. Very good. Very good. So you can make whistles from the pen cap. Okay. Next, take these bottles. One by one. Do. Very good. So you can make whistles from
bottles
also. Now, can you make whistles from this toffee wrapper?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is it? Okay. Each one of you take one toffee wrapper and then make whistle. You made it. Now try to blow on it. Very good. Can you make whistles from these leaves also?
Yes, sir.
Is it possible?
Yes, sir.
Yes. You take one, each one take one leaf and then make a whistle.
The remainder.
Made it. Very good. Now blow. Very good. You made it now. Now, I will ask you one thing. So, you have made whistles from different items. What are the things you made it? One,
pen cap.
Second,
bottles.
Toffee wrapper.
Leaf.
Four. Now, you tell me which has louder, which is the louder whistle?
Pen cap
is the louder whistle. Okay. Next, louder.
Bottles.
She found that the bottle is little louder. Next to that,
toffee wrapper.
And the very least softest one is
this one.
What is that?
Leaf.
Okay. So what you learned here now?
We learned how to make the whistle.
Whistle. How to make the whistle? Whistle with the different items. Okay. You made whistle earlier. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
Do you hear music at home?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay. Now, I have some music in my mobile phone. I am going to play it now. By closing your eyes, you should be able to recognize what music, what instrument it is. Can you do it?
Yes, sir.
Right. Close your eyes. Yes, Adi.
Mridanga.
Mridang. It is? Mridang. Okay, good. Next. Pona, can you tell?
Sir, guitar.
Guitar. It is? Guitar. Good. Oh, yes. Harsha?
Sir, flute.
It is?
Flute.
Good. Yes. Arun, what is it?
Drums.
It is a drums. So you are able to recognize the sounds. Based on that, you are able to recognize their instruments. Now, can you collect the pictures of those and can you paste in your record out?
Yes, sir.
Yes? Yes. Now, who knows playing flute? Oh, you all know. Good. I have only three flutes now. You take and play. Good, good. Very good. Very good. Very good. So you all know how to play
flute.
Flute. Very good. I have one more musical instrument. What is this one?
Mouth organ.
Mouth organ. Who is ready to play this? You all. Okay, good. Start. Very good. Very good. Nice. Very good. Till now you have learned that you are blowing on different ways or on different things.
So what are you doing?
What, Arun?
So what are you doing?
This one?
Yes, sir.
I am cleaning my spectacles.
How does it happen cleaning, sir?
Very good. So you asked a good question. Now, you are going to find the answer yourself by doing an activity. Shall we do it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, take this glasses. Blow it hard. How it looks?
So it looks hazy.
Now I have some mirror here. Can you make this mirror also hazy?
Yes, sir.
Oh, take it and do it. Good. Yeah, now can you tell me what makes it hazy by touching? Yes.
Sir, there are small water droplets on it which makes it hazy.
Very good. There are small water droplets that makes it hazy. Okay. Now from this, can you tell me the breathe out air, is it dry or wet? Yes, Mona?
Sir, it is wet.
It is wet. So it is wet. As he said, there are small water droplets which makes it wet. Okay. Now, Arun, you asked one question. Now, what is it?
So, what are you doing?
This I was cleaning the spectacles. And how this helps in cleaning, you asked. Is it not? Now, can you tell me the answer?
Yes, sir.
What is the answer?
The air you blew contains moisture.
Okay.
Which helps to clean your spectacles.
Very good. The air which I blew contains moisture, small water droplets. That helps in cleaning the spectacles. Okay? You got it? Okay. Shall we do the next activity?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now, keep your hand on your chest. Take a deep breath. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Now, when you breathe in, your chest comes out or goes in? Bhuvana?
It comes out, sir.
It comes out. So, the chest comes out. Now, I have a doubt. Any difference in our chest size when we breathe in and breathe out? Don't know?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Don't know. Shall we find out?
Yes, sir.
How can we find out?
By measuring our chest.
Very good. By measuring our chest with tape or thread. Now, I have two tapes with me. Take this. With your friend's help, you measure the chest and find out is there any difference. Okay. Get up. Take a deep breath. How much it is?
77, sir.
77. Yes.
66, sir.
66. Good. Note it. Note it. Order. Now, breathe out. Breathe out. Measure. How much?
60, sir.
60. Note. Yes?
74, sir.
74. Note it. So, what we found now? The chest size varies when we breathe in and breathe out. So, when these two process, what happens? The chest size varies. Shall we do another activity?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, keep your finger under the nose. Do you feel any air when you breathe out?
Yes, sir.
You feel?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, can we count how many times we breathe in 1 minute?
Yes, sir.
Can we count?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I will say start. You have to start counting. When I say stop, you have to stop counting. Okay? Ready? Ready? All of you ready?
Yes.
Right. Start. Stop. How many?
20, sir.
20.
20.
20.
20.
20. 21. 21. Oh, good. So, more or less same. Okay, now, suppose I jump for some time. Will my breath rate will vary? Will it increase or decrease?
Increase.
Increase. Sure.
Yes.
How do you know?
Because when we jump, it increases when after the tiredness.
Tiredness. Yes. Okay. Shall we check it again?
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
Get up. 30 count. I will stay. Start. You have to jump. After 30, stop. Okay. Shall we start?
Yes.
Start. 1, 2, 9, 30. Stop. Sit down. And then start counting. Start. Stop. Okay. How much?
40, sir.
40.
53.
43.
41.
41.
43.
So, when we do the exercise like jumping or heavy work, our breath rate
increases.
Our breath rate increases. Okay. Have you heard tick tick sound of clock?
Yes, sir.
Good. Have you seen the doctor using something to hear your chest? What is it called? Yes?
Sir, stethoscope.
Stethoscope. Good. What do you think what she is hearing from this chest?
She hears our heartbeat.
Your heartbeat. Very good. Do you like to hear your heartbeat now?
Yes, sir.
But we don't have stethoscope. What to do? Shall we improvise a simple stethoscope?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I have a funnel and
rubber
tube. Just connect these two and then this becomes the simple improvised stethoscope. Can you do it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I will give you the funnel and tube. You can improvise it. You made it?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Now, keep the funnel on your left side of the chest. Keep the tube on your ear. Hear carefully. Do you hear any sound?
Yes, sir.
What is the sound?
Dub, dub.
What is it?
Heartbeat.
It is the
heartbeat.
Then hear anything you have learnt?
How to make a stethoscope.
Very good. How to make an improvised stethoscope. Okay? Right. Now, we are going to do the last activity. Making snake. Are you afraid of the word snake?
Yes, sir.
Yes? No, don't get afraid. We are not making the real snake. We are making the paper snake by using the paper. I will demonstrate to you first how to do it, then later you do it. In a round paper, you make spiral circle like this. Then, using a scissor, you cut it spirally. Okay. At the center, you make a small hole. Take a thread, attach a button or a bead. Insert the thread in the hole and hang it. What is this one?
Snake.
It's a paper snake, spirally made paper snake. Now this you are going to sew it on the different hot items. It may be a candle, a burner or a teacup. Okay, you have to sew it and you will find, you tell me what is happening. Okay, are you ready to do it? Okay.
Yes.
Now you take these papers and scissor, small spiral round, you make it first. Good. Okay. Now you take the scissor and slowly you cut. Make a small hole at the center.
Sir, we made it.
Very good. Okay. Keep it down. Now we are going to test on which direction it rotates. Now you observe carefully and tell on which direction it rotates. All of you observe carefully. Observe from top. On which direction it rotates?
Clockwise.
Clockwise, sir.
Clockwise. Very good. All rotates on clockwise. On T it is less. On single candle it is better, but on the four candle it is still fast, but on the stove it is very fast. Now why it happens, anybody can tell?
When the air gets heated up, it becomes less weighted and goes up.
Very good. When the air gets heated up, it becomes less weight and it is going up. When air goes up, what happens? It makes the snake rotate in clockwise direction. So from this what we can understand, when the snake rotates in clockwise, we can understand that air flows upwards. Suppose I have a doubt, I go and show this snake under the fan, on which direction it may rotate? Very good, Adi.
Anti-clockwise.
Can you take this snake to your home and can you check and do it as a homework? Can you tell me tomorrow?
Yes, sir.
Arun, at the beginning you asked one question, no? What was the question you asked?
Blow hot and blow cold, it's same breath. How it is possible, sir?
Yes, you asked blow hot and blow cold with the same breath. How it is possible? You ask.
Yes, sir.
Have you got the answer now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, tell me, what is it?
Breathe out air can be hot or cold as compared to the temperature outside, sir.
Very good. The breathe out air can be hot or cold. It is depends upon the outside temperature. Okay. That is the point we have learnt. Okay. Anything else have you learnt in today's class? Yes, Adi?
We can use the warmth of our breath in different ways.
Very good. We can use the warmth in different ways. Next.
We can cool the hot things by blowing.
We can cool the hot things by blowing. Good. Next.
Sir, we learnt how to make paper whistle.
Paper whistle. She learnt how to make the paper whistle. Good. Anything?
We can make whistle with different things, sir.
We can make whistles with different things also. Okay.
The breathe out air is wet.
The breathe out air is wet. That also we have learned. Good. Next.
Chest size increasing when we breathe in.
When we breathe in, chest size increases. Very good. Next.
Our breathe rate increases when we jump.
Our breathe rate increases when we jump. Anything else?
How to make a funnel stethoscope.
How to make a funnel stethoscope. That skill we have learned. Oh, good.
Hot air has less weight than cold air.
Hot air has less weight than the cold air.
How to make a paper snake.
How to make a paper snake. See, learned. Good. Very good. Anything else?
The paper snake tells a flow of air.
The paper snake tells the flow of air. Very good. These are the points that we have learned in today's class. How was the class?
Very nice, sir.
Very nice. Very good. Then?
We enjoyed, sir.
You enjoyed. Very good. So today our class over. So thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.